Welcome to part 3 of episode 1 of the Anchorland podcast, Real Estate Conversations. Previously, we learned about the challenges that real estate investors face and how 202 Peak Lane Service Residences address these through property technology, its rental-ready features, and the leasing program. Let's now listen to what our expert guests have to say about the protected passive income features of 202 Peak Lane Service Residences.
When it comes to that, no, at the end of the day, the point is to simplify things for investors. What Anchorland aims to do is to simplify and to make efficient the process of becoming a real estate investor. And that in itself is already a huge value to investors. Trust me, that's something that we continuously strive to do for our investors. And that's something that I've seen is very, very much wanted by Davao City investors especially. They want something that is simple to understand. They want something that is not that much of a hassle on their part to manage. And they want to make sure, of course, that when they invest, they are going to make money from it. They are going to profit from it. So I think that has been well laid out with what you said, sir, no, na madali lang itong investment na ito, madaling intindihin, maganda ang location, maganda ang features, and the process of getting your money and the process of generating income is also going to be handled by someone else. So all you need to really consider is that magkano ba ang kikitain ko? Because may aspect sila dito sa Davao City that they want to have a good idea immediately. No, they want to have a good idea of how much they stand to earn when it comes to their investments. And once that they are comfortable with it, once they are happy with that kind of return, then it's, kumbaga, it's all systems go for them. They have the capacity to invest. So they just want to know how much they're going to get in return for their investment.
Very good points, Robbie. In fact, these were the things that we considered nung kinonceptualize yung Toto Peak Lane Service Residences, the West Tower. Kasi based on feedback from our existing clients from the Toto Peak Lane Park Suites, similar sa sinabi ni Stephanie kanina, magtatanong sila, I'm an investor, but I don't live here in Davao. I don't have the resources to manage a rental business. So how do I manage it? Anong pwede kong gawin? So with that in mind, inisip namin yung West Tower to give that additional service. And that was done through our leasing program. There are two competitive advantages itong leasing program. First, efficiency of the rental operation through additional, additional property technology features. And second is a protected, a secured passive income through a minimum guaranteed income. How does this work? So imagine mo, di ba, through the leasing program, you have someone that will be operating the rental business for you. It takes away all of the hassles that come with managing your own rental business, di ba? From from marketing to documentation to collection to maintenance and upkeep. While at the same time, the technology na ipinasok dyan that will be managed by the operator will really enhance the guest experience. So try to imagine, magbubook ka ng room, you use a mobile application for that. So from there, you can already pick on a date, anong time, anong room or type of unit you want to book. And it's very seamless. So technology-driven uli siya. From the mobile application, nabook mo na yung reservation. During the check-in process, di ba ano bang typical experience? Pipila ka sa check-in counter. Dito walang ganun. You have a self-check-in kiosk. And again, using the mobile application that is integrated in the hotel management operational system, seamless. Matatanggap mo na yung password mo na gagamitin mo sa digital lock set. You are given access to the elevator via a keycard access system na only, exclusive access eh. Only those authorized on certain floors or common areas will be able to access that area. So, and then you can go ahead and enjoy na your stay. During your stay, the technologies again will come to play. And very important dito, a technology that we are again developing is the integrated room automation system, which enables yung operator ng aking unit can automatically set up na at certain times of the day that the light will turn on, the curtains will open or close, the air conditioner temperature will go either lower or higher depending on the time of the day. So from the perspective of the guest, napaka-convenient. Diba? Pagpunta ko doon ng tanghali, automatic, nakabukas yung kortina, mas malamig na yung kwarto ko. And then from the perspective naman ng investor, eh makakatipid ka because everything is set up automatically as far as, again, efficiency is concerned.
Galing naman. Galing, Sir Arwin. Like, everything you're talking about, I'm imagining it in my mind. And I'm just imagining how convenient it is for everyone. Like, for example, like you mentioned, you make self-check-in kiosk. And then when you go into your room, you just use the lock set. And then when you have, you also have those controls for temperature, yung curtains. Parang naisip ko, it even feels like a luxurious experience eh. I love it.
Precisely. Sing again, technology-driven siya, di ba? You already have fiber optic technology there. So, why not use it? If you have fiber optic technology naman, you can pretty much set up your own smart home or smart unit, di ba? But if you really want to maximize the technologies available in the 202 Peak Lane service residences, join our leasing program and we'll take care of setting up that smart unit for you. And imagine, so you have your guests staying there, even yung at ito something that typically happens in a hotel, di ba, yung toiletries, you just give it away freely and you're not able to monitor. Next thing you know, inuuwi na lang pala ng mga guests in toiletries, di ba? Here, through the mobile application, you can also have your guest order the toiletries. So again, it's all about efficiency while at the same time it's being environment friendly kasi you're also minimizing your carbon footprint na hindi ka lang bigay ng bigay nitong mga toiletries, but it's something that they really ask for on demand or based on their need. So talagang it's very convenient as far as the guest experience is concerned as well kasi nga everything is done through technology all the way until you check out. So again, using the mobile application, you can settle everything for the checkout and then you just go on your way. So if you think about it, almost contactless yung stay because again it's all technology driven, so efficiency talaga ang dinadrive natin dito in the service residences and everything again can be done through the leasing program. Now in addition to that pa, maximizing your property technology and these new technologies that I just talked about, there's also the aspect of the protected passive income. This is a concern na I'm sure na na-encounter nyo ngayon sa mga investors. Di ba, hesitant sila maglabas ng pera kasi they're not sure ano ba mangyayari sa pera ko kapag nilabas ko, babalik pa sa akin yan. There's a lot of uncertainty ngayon eh. So to address that, actually even before the pandemic happened, we wanted to give that aspect of protection in the investment through a minimum guaranteed income na ibibigay sa investors regardless of what's the situation. So if you sign up for the leasing program, you get at a minimum of 3% of your total contract price as your annual lease. Oh. So that should give you the peace of mind na you're investing in this property that's being managed automatically by someone else for me. I just really need to sit back, relax, and wait. And my minimum of 3% will come in. Addition to that pa is you also get a free stay in your unit. So if you want to, you know, spend time on your own to maximize your investment, you can also live in your unit at your convenience. Just make sure lang that you book in as well using the mobile application and you can utilize your unit, enjoy it for 21 days in a year. And that's a value of at least 1.8%. So just imagine you're getting about 3.8% minimum per year back in your investment. That's just the minimum if you join the leasing program.
That's very attractive, sir. No, because the actual returns are already attractive. No matter the time period, getting approximately nearly 5% in value every year from your investment is already solid. And in your case, it's still just the minimum guaranteed. So there's actually more upside to this one. So this kind of program solves what investors in Davao are looking for, no? Which is they want guaranteed income. Of course, guaranteed income that is sufficient. No? Guaranteed income that is attractive. So they get that with you, but still get some of the upside from typical investments wherein they can get more than 3% per year. Tapos, it's an added perk pa that they have this 21-day free stay, which I think is very important right now because people do need staycations, di ba? That's something that I'm increasingly seeing from my friends as well on their Facebook timelines. They don't necessarily go out of the city, but they want to just take a break from the norm, which is they don't want to sleep in their own houses. They just want to go to a hotel. They just want to go to a nice place to rest and relax. And that's something I think that will be very, very attractive as well for the owners themselves. No, that's something that I think is going to
uso na yung also offer staycation value. Tama ka, Rob. Uso na yung staycation.
Especially now, di ba, na medyo madaming restrictions. Tapos, of course, it can, especially now that we're also working from home, most of us, it can get monotonous. No? It can get monotonous.
Totoo yan.
Staying in the same place.
Staying in the same place. Tapos, seeing the same things. So, parang, it's good to have a staycation every now and then.
Yeah, no matter how nice your place is or how comfortable you are, iba pa din yung may something fresh in your mind, in your life. So that's really, really great, no? And of course, my emphasis coming from an investment background, talagang it's that minimum 3% guaranteed. That's big for investors here. I think that's something that a lot of people will find attractive. And it's easy to understand, no? Invest here, you get 3% minimum guaranteed. And then should it go up, and now we're seeing signs of the economy recovering naman, so it stands to make more than that in the future. That to me is a good selling point, and I think that's something that specifically addresses the desires of Davao City investors, Mindanao investors actually.
Yung 3% guarantee, parang almost na rin siya time deposit, tama ba Rob? Parang similar?
Better. Not even. It's much better. Especially now that interest rates are down, time deposits are also really low right now. So this is much better than that. This is better than inflation.
Ang gandang pakinggan
yan. So you're beating inflation already.
yeah.
So you're beating inflation with this minimum guaranteed. So if it goes up, that's extra, that's bonus, that's much very much welcome.
Actually, it's very attractive for me because I'm selling a lot of developments, right? So hindi naman often that a developer will give a minimum guaranteed income. Oftentimes, walang minimum guaranteed income. So to have a guaranteed 3%, tapos on top of that, you can have the leasing profit pa, di ba? So I think it gives the investor peace of mind na yung investment ko, it will really give me returns. And not just the 3%, but I can also look forward to the added income from leasing. So I think for me, it's really good na meron siyang ganitong guaranteed income. It gives me peace of mind.
And hindi pa natin na-mention yan, syempre, eventually, property value appreciation will also happen.
Tama, yeah. I missed to mention that. Pero tama yan, Sir Arvin, kasi you have the guaranteed income, you have the lease income, and then someday, the investor can also look forward to appreciation of the properties. And being in the real estate industry, nakikita ko talaga yung appreciation, how it's really real. Like over the years, 9 years na ako dito sa industry na ito, I've seen how properties were priced before and how much they are selling for now. So ang laki ng difference. So it's also something that the investors can look forward to na someday, they can also flip the property if they want at a higher value. So they have the guaranteed income, they have the lease income, and then eventually they can even sell their units. So it's loads better than like time deposit. I'm sure Robbie would be the best person to say that.
Yes, it is. Definitely, it's kumbaga, it's really far away from what's being offered in the market right now in terms of returns. So that in itself is already a huge bonus for investors. One thing that I make sure that investors understand is that whatever asset they are investing in, it has to be backed by quality fundamentals. Now, what I mean by quality fundamentals is the developer behind the project. That's something that is very, very important. And that's something that something that investors look at. No? Kumbaga, the returns are a huge emphasis for them, of course. The more attractive it is, the more attractive it seems to them then. But their typical next question after getting the returns is, who is issuing this investment? Diba? Who is the issuer? Who is the developer? Who is the people? Who is the company behind this asset? That's the next question they ask. And that's something I think is going to be of good value then for investors of 202 Peaklane, because they need to understand being a publicly listed company in the Philippine Stock Exchange is not a small deal. I'm sure a lot of people understand that when you are a publicly listed company, you're subject to different guidelines. Now, they're much stricter. They're much more transparent. When you are a publicly listed company, it already stands to reason that you are a quality company. Now, the requirements for being listed alone are a lot. So the fact that you're listed, that's already huge. So it gives the project its credibility. And now you are assured that the company behind it has the ability to deliver on their promises. Now, the guaranteed income is only as good as the guarantor, di ba? It's only as good as the guarantor. And if the guarantor is a publicly listed company with a reputable history, that only reinforces the guarantee.
You can rest easy.
Yes, yes. And kung passive income especially ang habol mo, gusto mo talaga yung rest easy. I mean, the last thing that you're considering is to think too much about your investment. So you need to have that aspect covered. The fundamentals of the company behind the property should be solid. And I think it's pretty evident here.
That's also what I tell my clients whenever they're choosing a property to invest in. I always tell them, look at the developer. Look at the track record of the developer. Look at the projects that they've built before. If it's good, if it's also generating income for their previous investors, and I always tell them to look at the developer kasi that's where you can know that the property that you will have is of good quality. So, importante yan. Tama yung sinabi mo, Rob. Fundamentals eh.
Wow! Very interesting insights from everyone. So, what do all of these tell us? Anggap natin yung reality of what's happening now, di ba? That investors have valid concerns, especially nga these days, it seems napaka-volatile ng situation natin. But our world shouldn't stop. Ang focus natin dapat is to move forward. So this means for sellers, maging proactive tayo and upgrade our knowledge and selling skills. How do we do this? You can join different webinars or other online forums. And syempre, listen to podcasts, which gives you deeper insights on what's happening in the industry and ano yung mga points of discussion that we can use to elevate how we talk with our clients. For investors naman, let's be on the lookout for investments na in spite of the here and now, these investments will provide us protection for our investment. And one of those instruments, especially in Davao City, is 202 Peaklane Service Residences. And that's all the time we have for today. Sa ating mga listeners and followers, I'm sure marami tayong napulot na maganda from today's discussion. So once again, salamatan natin si Stephanie and Robbie for joining us today.
Thank you, Sir Arwin, again for having me here in this pilot episode. I'm really honored to be here. This was an insightful discussion, and I really hope that our listeners was able to learn something from what we talked about earlier. So for me, as a real estate broker who's been in the industry for 9 years, I've seen a lot of projects. So something that I really appreciated with 202 Peaklane is that it addressed the common issues and challenges that investors usually have. I appreciate that the project incorporated technology that allows you to manage your property even if you're not physically present. And I love that it offers guaranteed returns. So you can make sure that this investment is worth your while. And of course, it's developed by Anchorland, which is a reputable developer with an established track record.
Thank you, Stephanie.
Thank you, Sir Arwin, again for having me.
It's been an honor to be with you in the pilot episode.
Well, as for me, Sir Arwin, again, I'd also like to show my appreciation for inviting me over to your inaugural podcast. So congratulations for this wonderful event. No? And I do hope that we were able to offer a lot of value to our listeners here right now. And siguro before I go, I'd just like to say these few things. No? I'd like to simply recap what I believe are the things that every investor should consider when it comes to making a decision. So it's just four simple things really, no? So number one, let's stick to the basics, no? Let's stick to the basics of passive income. Passive income, in my view, should be a simple investment. No? It should be simple to understand. It should be simple to buy. It should be simple to sell. It should be simple to market. Aside from that, it should be backed by quality fundamentals. That's something that I cannot state any clearer. It should be backed by quality fundamentals. The person or the company behind it should be reputable. Number three, passive income, of course, should be able to provide regular income. It should be able to do so in a reliable fashion. And lastly, passive income or your investment should have the high opportunity for capital appreciation. I think if any investment, no, especially if you're looking for a passive kind of investment, any investment that checks all of those boxes, those four boxes right there, I think it's well worth your time considering. So hopefully we were able to really help you out when it comes to your decision making. Hopefully we were able to really lay out what it is as an investor that you should be looking for. You should have high standards from your investments. And that's something that I think was perfectly addressed here in this podcast. So with that said, Sir Arwin, again, to Miss Stephanie also, and to everyone involved in this podcast, thank you so much for inviting me. It's an honor, and I hope I was able to help out in my own small way. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Robbie. Suki ka namin dito. So I'm sure we'll be able to have more fruitful discussions in the future, especially, of course, with Stephanie as well. Her insights were very on the spot as far as ano ba yung mga situations, experiences even that sellers and brokers take a look at. Thank you to both of you for joining us on our pilot episode. And we look forward to having you again in succeeding na mga kwentuhan natin. To close this broadcast, I would like to leave one last tidbit for our listeners. Tandaan po natin that real estate is a cyclical investment. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Real estate as an investment goes through certain phases. So it may be active now and may be inactive later. And recently, the industry took a break, pero it's already starting to pick up now. The drivers of the industry are slowly turning and will soon regain momentum. Ibig sabihin ito, you don't want to be left behind when it starts to run again at full speed. Be a smart investor and listen to the experts who will give you professional and sound advice. And of course, listen to this podcast that will again give you more information, more insights on how you'll be able to manage your property investments. This has been Arwin Tolentino.
And this has been the Anchorland Podcast, Real Estate Conversations.
Catch us again in our next episode. Until then, thank you and stay safe.